What is the difference between beta-testing testing and red teaming, and which one should I focus on? So here's the thing. Beta-testing testing is basically carrying on an attack and or you can say an assessment to test the company security controls. Are there vulnerable? Is there any vulnerabilities there? And try to carry on an attack and see if you can get inside the organization and reach their critical systems. But in penetration testing, there's two main things that are missing. The first one is that you don't test the security team behind all of these defenses. You don't test the SOC team, you don't test the incident response team. They know about this attack, they know what the IPs are being used. They see the attack, they just don't react to it. So they let you do all your attack without them detecting or without them stopping you or preventing you from this attack. You only test the security controls of the organization. That's the first thing. And the second thing, that you don't build this attack based on intelligence data, based on threat intelligence. You don't simulate real attacks that happen in the world. So you might be focusing on web vulnerabilities, you might be focusing on different public facing surfaces, whatever you found vulnerabilities in them or not. These are not the highest priority for the organization right now, because the attacks that are actually happening on the organization are coming through spear phishing attacks or endpoints, whatever the type of attacks they use against endpoints. So you're focusing on the server side, where the real attacks are focusing on the client side. And you give a different sense of what is the vulnerabilities that needs to be brutalized, that needs to be patched right now. For an organization, it's really important for them to know they have tons of vulnerabilities. There's no organization that patched all the vulnerabilities, that has they don't have misconfigurations, they don't have any issue. All the organizations, they have tons of vulnerabilities they need to fix, tons of alerts they need to read, and so on. But the idea is what to brutalize first. And if you are working just in penetration testing or in penetration testing assessments, it might not give a good sense of what needs to be brutalized first. Penetration testing assessments are still useful for different, for compliance, for basic security controls, but it doesn't provide, it's not based on intelligence, it's not based on, doesn't improve the security team, which is why red teaming comes and help. So red teaming is all about simulating real attacks, is looking at what the attacks is happening right now against this organization or similar organization to this one. And then from there, they start to simulate these attacks, starting to follow their tactics and techniques and procedures, creating their own special malware or weapons, or even using tools that has been encrypted and obfuscated enough to bypass most security controls and defenses. They carry their attack against the security controls, against the security teams working there. They have no idea this attack is actually happening, or this red teaming assessment is actually happening, and the attack is running in complete black box. They are going through all the defenses, they are bypassing all the defenses and really testing the organization against the attacks that's happening nowadays, happening to them or to organizations like that. So that's how red team is really, really important for organization. So if you are building your career in the offensive side, which one you should focus on? Well, in penetration testing, you learn the basics, the foundation of the offensive side and of how the attack actually work. But to really become competent, to really become one of the top candidates applying for any penetration testing jobs, then focusing on red team and learn how real attacks look like is the next level that will take you from here to there, take your career and your resume into way higher level, because you understand the real attacks. Now you are worth to the company you're working for, whatever you're working for, a company to carry assessments for, or to another organization that carries assessments to other companies. You are worth all the attacks that you are saving the organization from, or saving the clients of your organization from. You are worth the millions you will be using in these targeted ransomware attacks or different EBT attacks that's happening. So this is how worth you are. Penetration testing is something that is now the majority of people has went through studying penetration testing at some point. Most of people who start in cybersecurity start with penetration testing. That's how I started. And they move maybe to incident response or to malware analysis. But there's so many people who hear about cybersecurity through penetration testing. There is way more candidates than the jobs that are actually opening for this type of jobs. So to really stand out, you need to jump from penetration testing to red teaming. From how I can do simple attacks, just using Metasploit and Kali Linux and all of that, to actually how I can simulate a real attack, how I can carry an attack that's similar to nation state attacks or target ransomware attacks or the attacks that cost companies millions of dollars. This is how valuable this type of knowledge or this type of attacks are. So my advice to you is that learn the penetration testing until you have the foundation, the basic foundation, and then move to red teaming and learn how the real attacks actually look like and carry out these red teaming assessments for you. That's my video for today, and see you in the next video.